start the second chapter of physics, electrostatic potential and capacitance. Okay, so we are going to start the chapter. In this we are going to talk about the potential energy of the electrostatic force. Now electrostatic force or a field is just like the gravitational force or field is conservative. Okay, so when you say conservative force, that means when you talk about the path, it will not have any difference of the path. Okay, it will be independent of the path. So when you are talking about the potential energy in the electrostatic phase, it will be due to the initial position and the final position. Okay, now we are going to start first what do you mean by potential energy also and potential at the point. So now you consider a positive charge, you can take negative also, but you have, for the simplicity, you have taken a positive charge q. And we are going to bring another positive charge q from point R to P. Now we have learned that when there is any charge, it will create an electric field around it. Okay? So now if this is a positive charge, it will create the field around it, okay, towards the outside. It will be outward. Now when I am bringing this charge q, now you can see this is positive charge, this is on the positive charge. So when I bring here from R to P, it is coming from here to here. So the electric field because of this charge q is outward, and I am bringing this towards the inside. That means the force is towards this side, and the displacement is brought towards this side. Okay. So what happens here? We need to do some external work. Okay. Because there is a force because of this charge q, the electric force because of this, that is towards the away from here. Okay, outward. But I want to bring this q against this electric field and towards this side. So that means we are going to do some work in bringing this to this point. So when we are doing that work, and that work will be stored as the potential energy at that point. Okay. So now let's go through what the points are written is. Consider electrostatic field E due to some charge configuration. For simplicity, field E due to a charge Q placed at origin. Okay. So we consider that this Q is the charge placed as the origin. Now a test charge, that is this plus Q charge, from a point R is brought to point P. Okay, as I said before, we are bringing from P, from R to point P, against the repulsive force on it due to charge Q. Okay, I was telling you that charge Q also will create its electric field, and you are going to bring this positive charge from R to P against this electric field. In bringing Q from R to P, we apply an external force F external just enough to counter the repulsive electric force F of E, that is electric force because of the charge, there is electric force, and I still want to bring the positive charge against this, so we have to give just counter this, means just more than this, so that I can bring the, I have to give the force against this, countering this or equal to this, so that I can bring the positive unit charge to the in the electric field of Q or to the point P. Now the work done by external force, that is F external, it will be same as this but in opposite direction, because I am going to bring it from outside, so I am going to force from outside and the electric force is towards this side. So one is from this side, one, so they are in opposite direction, but it should be equal. Then only we can bring it in the given point. The work done by external force is stored in the form of potential energy of charge Q. Okay, I was telling you that when we are going to do the work, and it will be stored as the potential energy at that point for the point Q, for charge Q. Mathematically, we can write it W, that is work done in bringing the charge Q from R to P, is equal to it's the force into the displacement. Now let's take the displacement as dr. Okay, we are not going to take the full displacement. Suppose the distance from here, this distance is r. Okay, this distance is r, and you are going to bring this. So we will take the small displacement. Okay, that small displacement, because the distance from here, the distance of r from q and p from q is it will be different. Okay, so if I take directly from here to here, it will be changing. So instead of changing, taking whole, we consider small parts. Okay, so I consider dr, the displacement dr, small dr, not taking the full displacement from R to P, but if I divide into equal parts or small parts, dr, okay, to in order to just take a constant. Okay, so F external is into dot dr, the force into the displacement d to the work. And I am going to take a small displacement, so I'll integrate from R to P, the whole distance from R to P in by dividing into small parts. Now as I said, F external will be equal to electric force. Okay, F of E, electric force, but it will be opposite direction. So I am writing negative sign. Electric field is this side, and we are giving the work from outside. Okay, so it will be negative of opposite direction of the air. Call it equation one. At point in electric field, a particle with charge Q possesses a certain electrostatic potential energy. Now this is true for all. When there is electric field in each point, there will be potential energy. Okay, if in electric field is there, that means in at each point there will be some potential energy at each point. But when you are bringing this by doing some work, if you are bringing the charge Q by doing some work, okay, the potential energy will increase, and it will be the increment will be equal to the work done. Okay, so potential energy is there in each electric field. But when you are bringing charge from infinite or from outside other place to in the electric field, it will be work done, and therefore it will be stored as the potential energy. Though there is potential energy at every point, by doing the work, okay, the potential energy will be increased. Okay, and that we call it as a equal to potential energy difference between points P, R and Q, R and P. Therefore, potential energy difference. Now we are going to write what will be potential energy difference. Okay, so potential energy difference will be delta U is for energy equal to UP minus UR. Potential energy at P minus potential energy at R. I am going to bring the point charge from P to R. We are going to do some work, so it will be equal to WRP. So the work done equal to the change in the potential energy. Okay, then. Now this we are going to write in the statement form. Therefore, electric potential energy. Okay, we put PED, potential energy difference. Electric potential energy difference between two points is the work required to be done by an external force in moving without acceleration charge Q from one point to another point. For point charge Q from one point to another for electric field of any arbitrary charge configuration. So in any charge configuration, if I am going to bring a charge, then it will be told as it should be as the potential energy difference. Okay. Once again I will read electric potential energy difference between two points, here P and R. Okay, is the work done, WRP, work done. Okay, required to be done by an external force, and this is done by external force. And we are going to bring without acceleration, with a slow speed. Okay, therefore we are going to take the displacement as small dr. Okay, then only we will not have the acceleration. Okay, the charge Q from one point to another point in the electric field. Okay, it is not just simply, but it is we are going to bring in the some electric field. So these things will happen in the presence of electric field of any charge. Okay. Then I have written 2-3 points here. This is between two points. Now we are not going to write about two points. We are going to talk about the infinite. Okay. So I mentioned the electrostatic force is a conservative force. If it is conservative force, that means the work done by electric force is independent of path. Okay. So as I said before, when there is a conservative force, any work done is independent of the path. That means, suppose you are bringing this charge Q, this small charge Q. Okay, this is R point and this is P point. Okay, from here to here you are bringing. So you can take any path. You can take this path. You can take this path. Okay, any path you can take, it will not affect. Okay, the potential difference will be same because it is conservative force. So it is path dependent. It is not necessary that you bring in a straight path or any other path. It will depend only the final position and the initial position. Okay, so when there is conservative force, that is a characteristic of the conservative force, that it is always path independent. Okay, so that is one thing you have to remember. zero at infinity. Okay, at infinity you consider the potential energy is zero. So now instead of this R, we have taken R in the figure, not so far, but we consider that R is suppose at infinite. Then work done in bringing the positive unit charge from infinite to P will be equal to the potential energy at P minus U infinite. Okay, energy at P minus infinite. Okay, and this is we are considering as the zero. Okay, we have written here electrostatic potential energy is taken zero. So this is electrostatic potential energy will take zero at infinite. So work done will be equal to UP alone. This is zero. So work done is equal to UP. That is potential energy of the point P. Okay, this always we take as infinite. So now we will not talk about P and R. We talk about from infinite, and we'll consider that at infinite potential energy is always zero. Just like the gravitational force, we will, if gravitational energy, if we consider them, for gravitational potential energy at infinite is zero. Okay, we have learned in class 11. So similarly here we are going to consider for electrostatic force also the potential energy is zero at infinite. Okay, so now with this, okay, with infinite and P, we are going to define the what do we mean by the potential energy. So potential energy of a charge Q at a point in the presence of the field due to any charge configuration is the work done by the external force equal and opposite to electric field in bringing charge Q from infinite to that point. So that means this is the same, okay, what we have written is the same, but this is, we have now for convenience sake we have taken instead of R as infinite. Okay, and this will be the final definition. So the definition is not what is potential energy of a charge, then you should write this definition. In that we have to find work done. Okay, we are now going to define there mathematically how we will write the potential energy. So work done, W slash D means work done by an external force in bringing a unit positive charge from infinite to a point is defined as electrostatic potential V at that point. Okay, so remember this definition, electrostatic of the point, what will be that? So work done in bringing against the external field a positive charge to that point from infinite, we call it as the electrostatic potential capital V. Okay, and we are going to write delta V. Here it was energy only. Okay, here it is potential. So delta V is equal to Vp minus Vr. And if I am going to take infinite, this R point, that should be 0. Up minus Ur by 2 is equal to Wrt by Q. Okay, this is what is written. Okay, the work done in bringing a charge from infinite to that point, or from R to P. Okay, this is our textbook, they are writing R to P, so I have just taken from R to P. Otherwise, we can write from infinite to P. Okay, with the next point I have taken. Now we go to equation number 1. Okay, equation number 1 was work done in bringing the point from R to P is equal to minus integration R to P F external force dot dr. Okay, then E external, instead of that we are, this is F electric force. Okay, so I am writing only F. Then instead of F, this is, since this force in electric field, I can write as Q into E. Okay, the any charge Q kept in the electric field will experience the force, and that force will be equal to Q into E. This is from chapter 1, that F is equal to Q into E in any charge, in any field, electric field. Okay, so I am putting instead of F, Q into E, the value of F in electric field. Okay, the force in electric field. Then I am just going to transfer this to this side. Okay, then W infinite P. Now I am going to take instead of R, as the convenient taken then, R can be taken as infinite. So instead of R, we are going to put infinite. And I will now transfer this Q, I will transfer below this, okay. So this time when I transfer, it becomes W work done in bringing Q from infinite to P divided by Q. Okay, and this side remains minus integration infinite to P E dot dr. Now, this ratio from this definition, okay, this ratio from this definition is called the potential. Okay, you will work done by an external force in bringing a unit positive charge from infinite to that point. Okay, so work done in bringing a point unit positive charge Q from infinite to P. Okay, this ratio we call it as a potential. Okay, potential V at point P, because here I have taken point P, otherwise you can just write as V. Okay, but since P is there, we are just putting the suffix as V of P. Okay, so remember this is one formula. The work done in bringing the unit positive charge from infinite to that point is called the potential of that point. Okay, VP or V. Potential of that point is called work done in bringing a point P or any bringing a unit positive charge from infinite to that point. So this ratio we call it as the potential of that point. Okay, and if I just transfer this Q here, now I am just neglecting this P and I am writing work done in bringing charge from infinite to P, Q into P, just transferring this here. So this is one formula, we are going to use this. So please remember W by Q is equal to V. Okay, work done divided by the charge is equal to the potential. Okay, this you remember in words that work done divided by the charge is equal to the potential. Okay, and this is also another form from here. Now what about the unit? Now work done is work done's energy, right? So the unit for work will be joule. Okay, and Q is a charge and its unit will be coulomb. And that's why joule or coulomb is the unit of potential, but it has given a special name called volt. Okay, so and its symbol is used, the capital V. Okay, capital V is used for the potential. So please remember the definition. Thank you very much.